Hello friends, in my previous video, I have already discussed about the inverting action of the NMOS inverter. Okay, so basically you can see here this is one NMOS inverter and its corresponding transfer characteristics graph, that is input versus output graph, is drawn here. First the NMOS is in cutoff, then saturation, then it goes to linear. I have explained the working of this circuit in detail in my previous video. You can check the link from the description. Okay. So let us in this video, let us try to understand how this NMOS inverter can be used in this concept, that inverting action of the NMOS can be used in some practical circuit application. Okay, so basically in this video we are going to discuss the inverting action application of NMOS. Okay, so see, this is basically one circuit which is given to you, and this circuit has a particular characteristics. That is, this circuit is basically negative feedback amplifier. And in this video, I am going to discuss that why this is a negative feedback amplifier. That means, what is the reason that this circuit is providing negative feedback? First of all, you should understand what is the importance of negative feedback. There are several advantages of the negative feedback, and it will be disadvantages also. I have already explained in detail about the negative feedback amplifier. I shall post the link of the negative amplifier playlist in the description. You can check from there. Okay, so basic concept of negative feedback amplifier is, suppose if the input voltage increases, the circuit will not allow it to increase. And suppose if the input voltage decreases, then the circuit will not allow it to decrease. Okay, that means it will try to keep all its voltages or current as its previous value only. It will not allow any change. Okay, that is negative feedback. Okay, so now let us try to observe how this circuit is providing negative feedback. So what we will do, we will increase the Vs and we will observe that whether the circuit is trying to decrease the effect of the increment of Vs. If it is trying to oppose the effect of increment of Vs, then obviously it will be called as negative feedback amplifier, right? So basically I am now starting the working of this circuit. Okay, so basically see, here are two transistors, Q1 and Q2. Okay, fine. Now see what will happen. So first of all, let us assume that due to some reason, this Vs is basically what? Voltage coming from function generator, right? Due to some reason, Vs is increased. Suppose manually increased or due to noise, it is increased. Okay. Now let us try to observe what is happening with this circuit. As Vs increases, what will happen? You apply KVL in the input loop and tell me what is the KVL equation. So KVL says, Kirchhoff's voltage law says, the voltage drop in a complete loop should be equal to zero. That means minus Vs plus VGS1 plus VF, that is voltage across this RF resistor, equal to zero, right? That's what we are getting from the Kirchhoff's voltage law, right? There is some potential drop across Vf, so Vf minus Vs, because here the minus sign is there, so minus Vs plus VGS1 equal to zero. Fine. So from here, what we can say, VGS1 equal to Vs minus Vf, right? Now let us assume that Vs is increased somehow. So as the Vs is increased, from the equation itself, what is clear, that if Vs is increased, for the time being you just take constant value of Vf. Later we will check what is happening to Vf, but as we are for the time being, up to now we have not got any information regarding Vf. Let us take Vf as constant. So initially Vs is increased, so from the equation itself it is clear, as Vs increases, VGS1 will increase, right? So that's what I have written here, VGS1 will increase. Now see, VGS1 is what? VGS1 is basically the input voltage for this NMOS. Okay, now see, consider this configuration. This highlighted part and this circuit are basically same only, just little bit difference is that here, for stability in the gain, what we have done, we have applied one extra source resistance. Okay, one resistor RF is connected with the source, which is again also providing feedback voltage. That is different, I will discuss later. But one only RF is there. Okay. Apart from that, this only this part and this circuit is same. So basically, here also inverting action of the NMOS inverter is applicable. So as VGS is increased, VGS1 will increase. As VGS1 is increased, obviously we can say that is drain potential. That is here this potential, which is basically VG2 or gate. Why VG2? Because the drain of the Q1 is short circuited with the gate of the Q2, right? So basically this point is getting the potential VG2, because gate potential of QT equal to drain potential of Q1. So basically we can say as drain VS increases, VGS1, that is gate to source potential for the Q1, increases. So as a result, due to inverting action of NMOS, VG2 will what? Decrease, right? Due to inverting action. That's what I have written here. VG2 decreases. Clear? Now see, as VG2 decreases, and for the Q2 transistor, again here same thing you can see for this highlighted part. Consider this highlighted circuit and this circuit are same only. So basically this circuit is acting again like an inverter. So as VG2 decreases, understand it carefully, as gate potential for Q2 is decreasing and source is grounded, so source potential is anyway zero. So basically as gate potential is decreasing, so we can say VGS2, that is gate to source potential for Q2 transistor, is decreasing. As VGS2, which is basically input for the Q2, is decreasing, so basically V output will increase due to inverting action of the Q2 transistor. Right? Clear? So as VGS2 is decreasing, V output will increase. Now see carefully, just observe the mouse pointer. From here we are starting, then R2, then RF, then it is going to ground. So basically, if you consider this path, this is itself acting like a voltage divider path. So if you apply the voltage divider rule, which you already studied in your basic network theory or fundamentals of electrical circuit course, from there you can say VF is equal to V output into RF by RF plus R2. Now as V output is increasing due to decrease in VGS2, what will happen? See, from this equation, as V output is increasing, VF will what? Increase, right? Because RF by RF plus R2 is anyway going to be constant. As V output increases, VF increases. Now see, here comes the funda. As VF increases, see this equation, as VF increases, initially at the beginning what we have assumed, just have taken one assumption, that let us assume VS is increased. Now we can see that VF is also increased. So as VS is increased, VF is also increased. So overall, VS minus VF, this whole term will remain almost constant. So as a result, VGS1 remain as constant only. As VGS1, that is input for the Q1, is remaining almost constant. So basically, this increment of the VS is affecting nothing in this circuit. Okay, so basically this is nothing but negative feedback. VS is increasing, but it is not affecting the circuit. VF, that is feedback voltage, is adjusted in such a way that it will keep the original input, which is VGS1 for this circuit, remains same as it is. Okay, so that's what's the basic principle of the negative feedback. In this case, as VS is increased, VGS1 is increasing. So due to inverting action of the Q1 NMOS, VG2 is decreasing. As VG2 is decreasing, VGS2 is decreasing. As VGS2 is decreasing, due to inverting action of Q2, V output is increasing. As V output is increasing, VF is increasing. As VF is increasing, from this equation we can say VGS is almost remains constant, which is original input for this amplifier, right? VGS1 is the original input, which is kept constant although we are increasing VS. So basically, the circuit is not allowing to change the original input signal. So this is what? Negative feedback. Okay, clear? So basically, this is how this negative feedback amplifier works. So this is the basic overview of that. Okay, so basic, the base of explanation of the working of this circuit is nothing but the NMOS inverter. So you should understand it's very clear concept that this circuit, this simple circuit, acts like one inverter. That means when input is increased, output is decreased. When input is decreased, output is increased. Okay? You can check the description for detailed explanation of this NMOS inverter. This is all for my this video. If you find this video helpful for your preparation, please like, share and comment and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. And for more videos related to electronics and communication engineering, please go to my channel and check the playlist so that you can access all the videos serially. I have uploaded feedback amplifier and the oscillators and the passive filters and many MATLAB funda with some fun in mathematics I have uploaded. You can check that. Thank you.